Hey guys, I'm Lorenzo from Cinegum.net and welcome to a different kind of Copycat Friday. As you guys can see, Yannick is currently not sitting here because he's enjoying a nice warm sunny vacation while I'm here all alone working on this Copycat Friday. And it's not like Jordi or Jill is helping me at all, because Jordi is stuck inside his new VR world and Jill, he's currently stuck in dancing.
I can't stop.
But anyways, let's get right into it. For today's episode, we'll be taking a look at the new music video pickup from DaBaby. Visual effects don't always need to be realistic, as you can see right here, where DaBaby is getting pulled through his phone with his typical cartoonish look, which honestly looks really cool and fun. But before we can recreate this effect, we need to take a few shots. Get yourself a tripod and slam your camera on it. I'll let Jordi hold his phone and act out the scene where he gets pulled through his phone. As you saw, Jordi's shirt collar moved. This we did with a simple fishing wire taped to the inside of his shirt to make it look like someone is grabbing him. We also used the Aperture Nova to mimic the magical light coming from the phone. Next up are two green screen shots. One where you act out the arm going up and pulling someone down. Here again, we used an aperture to mimic the light coming from the phone. And another green screen shot of your phone flipping in the air, which we did by holding some fishing wire and pulling the strings. And of course, we need an empty shot, so let your camera roll for a few seconds. After this, I let Jordi take place again and tilt the camera down to get a shot of his lower body. This is because later on, we'll need to attach his legs to his upper body again. Last but not least are the light rays. This you can make in After Effects, or you can use Storyblocks Video. There you can find every single light ray your filmmaking heart desires. Next to this, they also have a huge stock library of HD and 4K footage. They have overlays, transitions, After Effects templates, just like this one for example. Easily add your own logo and have a cool animation in seconds. Basically, it has everything you will ever need. And I know, my amazing sales pitch already sold you. But there's more. For only one single price per year, you have access to unlimited downloads. So start downloading right away and go to the first link in the description down below. And now that we have all our shots, let's open up After Effects. Drag your empty shot, acting shot, and the green screen shot of the arm onto your timeline. Take the green screen shot and draw a rough mask around the arm at the point where it would grab Jordi. Drag the key light effect onto the clip and remove the green. Match the position and the scale of the arm so it looks like the hand comes out of the phone and grabs Jordi. And finally, animate the position and the bottom of the mask so it sits perfect within the phone. Next up, drag the green screen shot of the phone to your timeline. Draw a mask around it, animate it, and use a key light effect to key it out. Now look for the point where the arm disappears after it has pulled Jordi down. Go 10 frames further in time and drag that phone shot on the point where it just starts spinning. From this point, go back until where the arm pulls Jordi in and make a cut by using Ctrl+Shift+D. Delete the left part of that clip. Reposition the phone where it should be and drag this clip one layer down. As you can see, the phone will now drop after the arm has disappeared in the screen. And now comes the fun part. We'll be creating the effect where Jordi gets sucked in into the phone. Go to the point where we just made our last cut. Select the layer of Jordi, make a cut and freeze frame it. Now mask him out. This doesn't need to be too perfect. Drag in the clip of his legs, freeze frame it, and again mask out his legs. Select the masked out body of Jordi and make a duplicate by pressing Ctrl+D. Select the duplicate layer and scale it down. Select the masked out legs and drag it under the duplicate. Adjust the position and scale so it looks like Jordi has a whole body again. Now pre-comp those two layers and use the position and scale to match this layer to the original you just made. Once that is done, delete the original. Move that pre-comp layer above the green screenshot of the phone. With this layer selected, make sure you are at the beginning of this clip and click on the puppet pin tool. Now add pins on every joint of his body and the top of his head. You can move the layer up to be able to put the pins on the legs and feet, but don't forget to move it back afterwards. Now go a few frames further in time and start animating until you reach the point where the phone starts to flip. It should look something like this. As you can see, the whole body doesn't go through the phone, so we need to fix that. Now we'll need to be precise with our animation. So move that pre-composed layer under the phone. Pre-comp the pre-composed layer again, look for the mesh warp effect and drag that on top of your clip. Increase the rows and columns and drag in the points around the phone so it squeezes everything inside the frame of the phone. Now mask away everything that shouldn't be visible once Jordi is sucked in. Invert that mask, add a feather to it, move that layer on top of the phone layer And don't forget to enable motion blur. As a final touch, simply add your stock clip of the light burst, blend that layer and animate the opacity. And if you can't find a stock clip, you can just use CC Light Burst 2.5 inside of After Effects. And that's it! So normally it's time now for a Janik fun fact fountain, but as you can see, I'm not Janik and I also don't have any fun facts.
No, Lorenzo, that's not true, Lorenzo. Guys, I think that there is a fun fact. And the fun fact is that Lorenzo did a great job today, didn't he? Let me know in the comments, guys. Should we replace Janik with Lorenzo? I think we should. He's much cheaper than Janik.
I didn't know that. Alright guys, so as Jordy just said, go into the comments and let us know if I did a good job or not. Thank you guys for watching, thank you Storyblocks for the support, and as always, stay creative.
It's Friday, Copycat Friday, and we're gonna party like Lorenzo.